Hi, Con here.
I'm just calling Bundy. Okay. Hey Bundy, it's John Wanoa here. Hope your hui's going well up there. I just got an email back from Te Unga Waka Marae in Epsom. They've let us have it. Dates 29th and 30th of September 2017 are available at present. Accommodation, hall, kitchen facilities. There is room for 30 people for sleeping. You will need to tell me number of extra people for sleeping. Please note, sleeping rooms are on the second floor of the marae, just in regards to age appropriateness. Ngā mihi, Paula Hakaraya, it's the reception, 021-231-8401. So, I'm going to put a deposit down on it to hold it, and if I know how many are coming, then I'll make sure there's space for the older people, the kaumātuas and queer, who will come down. It'll be good to know who's coming. I'll make an announcement to publicly tomorrow. I was just waiting for this to come down, confirmation to come back, and so I'll secure that as soon as. But to let them know how many people, so I'll know that on Monday when you get back. Okay? Thank you, Bundy. All good here. Going to put a video on tonight and again tomorrow. Okay? Bye. So that's Bundy. I might give Manahi a ring. His phone just might go. I'll ring. I like to keep them in touch. I'm feeling better now. I like to be spot on. Yeah, Manahi, is John Wanoa here. We have secured the marae in Epsom, Te Unga Waka Marae, for the Friday the 29th and Saturday the 30th. So the court hearing will start at 3 o'clock, and that's all we need was 1 hour at least to do the court hearing. It will be all over, and then we can go into other matters after that and all day next day. Okay, I hope everything's going good up there, up north. I'll have a video out today and tomorrow. I'll just put one on tonight for today, in readiness to alert the government and John Key and those ones I'm going to take into court. We'll be making a start on the magistrate manual tomorrow. Okay? Thank you very much. Bye. Now I'll just ring Desmond. I'll just text him. I'll text Desmond. By the way, Desmond is filling in for me. He knows more than anybody else at this stage, and I'm making sure our family's saying the right things in the history of Moai and the history of Moriori, the Manukaus and the Wānaus. That's who I can only speak for them and those kings that I'm claiming that title of commerce, private contract too. Okay, that's Desmond. Right. Send him a text. Oh, you... right. So, really, I just wanted to say, to finish off the last video with John Key, that we are taking him into court. We are taking others into court as well, on the same day. On the 29th, I'll make this announcement, on the 29th of August, 29th of September, which is a Friday, 2017, we are having a Native Magistrate Court Grand Jury hearing in Te Unga Waka Marae in Epsom, on the corner of Clyde Road and Manukau Road. That's only about 200 metres up from Broadway and Great South Road intersection. Lights there. It's not that far up there. But I'm making a announcement, public announcement, that those who are attending the hui is open to the public. It's open to the public because I'm there for the public to bring into account the fraud in this country. For a start, here first and then other native countries affected by the same pirates running the racket here in New Zealand with John Key, and now Bill English is keeping that legacy going. We're going to put a writ warrant on their heads personally, their businesses, their assets, their everything, because it's going to stop right there. We have the jurisdiction of this flag, of the King, at the beginning of how you got here on this land in the first place. If you can't prove in defence of me on this video, live, person, man, natural name, Hoani Kahaki Wānoa, or John, and corporate name, the same name in capital letters, I'm claiming that too. And its fortunes back into the King's Bench Court and magistrate, native, and the paramount chiefs of this country. I have only three paramount chiefs here. I myself is a paramount chief, the fourth one. So I'm taking our Wānoa name all the way back to Rapa Nui, East Island, to Mokonui on New Zealand, on the East Coast, Te Pito there, to Te Pito on Rapa Nui, to Te Pito on Mokonui, Urupa Memorial, land, Urupa. So I'm taking our name and the Manukau name into the Magistrate Court in Auckland with Bundy Waitai, Paramount Chief for Cook Island, Tahitian, Ngāpui, and Manahi Parapara Mohini Moriori for the Mohini Parapara and Manukau native families, the legitimate original native owners of this country. Not the Solomons, that's Pākehā. That's on the Queen's Crown Corporation side, that's getting the bill. You're getting the bill over there from us on your Queen's Bench Court, from the King's Bench Court on this side. Now, I'm reading through all the notes on the courts that I can legally hire the court in Auckland, any court, for a court hearing of this magnitude and authority on our own Moriori, Manukau, Cook Island, Tahitian, Ngāpui land. I'm only speaking for Ngāpui no one else. They can speak for themselves. Tainui and Arawa can speak for themselves. I'm only speaking for the Manukau family, the Wānoa family, and these kings. King William III, King William IV, King George IV, King George III, and King Ernest Augustus I, and King Ernest Augustus, the living king of Britain, UK, Hanover, and Aotearoa, New Zealand, Pacific Islands, and the Commonwealth countries of the world, nominated by us, the paramount chiefs, in contract with all those kings. Okay, you got that? We're in a private contract of admiralty, court martial law, jurisdiction, with all those kings I just said, with this flag and the 8-point star of St. Patrick's in Downpatrick County in Belfast, my Cosgrove family and Rogan family, married my family, come from there. That's our title, and the Moai statue standing in London that the Queen, Victoria, stole in 1868 of Rapa Nui. That's my title. In this court hearing in Auckland, Moai Crown, Moai Powerhouse Bank creditor, Moai Crown Whakamininga, Paramount Chiefs, 1834. Declaration of War flag. It's a state of emergency flag over New Zealand and Pacific Islands for threatening the Paramount Chief's financial investment interests in the King's Bench Court, royal revenue and prized possessions and land, patent land, crown title. Absolutely. You get that? You got that? I'm making this video citation, fact, evidence for the court hearing on Friday, the 29th of September 2017 in Te Unga Waka Marae in Epsom at 3 p.m. Jonky, you've got to turn up and defend yourself, because if you don't turn up, it's a default contract on your head from King William III, King William IV, and King Ernest Augustus V, live man in England, and us, the Paramount Chiefs, and the Moai, and the Moriori, title holders of this country, that you've obliterated on your documents from your New Zealand company, New South Wales, Australia. You're in trouble. You're all getting the bill because you are stealing our 8-point star. That's our authority. It's not your authority. You can't prove it. You can't prove you're a Dutch bloodline to King William III and King William IV and our contract you have no business with. You are a fraud family, Prince William. I'm talking to you, and Queen Elizabeth II, you have no coronation, legal. You were fraud right from the start, 1952, when you became Queen. It should have been King Ernest Augustus. It should have been the King, King Ernest Augustus V. You changed the records with Evelyn Rothschild and Nathan Rothschild and all those family, and fabricated and corrupted the whole King's Bench Court titles. For that, it cost you. And I'm making this public announcement that the public is invited to come to that native grand jury trial magistrate court hearing in Clyde Road, the corner of Clyde Road and Manukau Road in Epsom on Friday the 29th of September 2017. I'm making this announcement now. I'll put it on Facebook and put all the details there And the public, we're there for the public. Moai Crown is for 70% of the population of the world against 30% of the elite families and the Crofton, Rothschild banks, the royal family, IMF, UN, EU, and all their Bilderbergs, ISIS, Israel, US Federal State, Washington DC, City of London, private companies, Queen Elizabeth II private company, Vatican City private company, Pope, Church and State, all the Church and State parliaments that have corrupted King William's titles and his commercial trading bank money system. You have defrauded us, the beneficiaries of this country and the public of New Zealand. 30% of you in New Zealand population are considered elite and debtors. The creditors being 70% of the population of New Zealand, I'm making this statement, are claimants to the King's Bench Native Grand Jury Court here and Westminster Magistrate Court, London, and the High Court of Admiralty in London, where this case is going to. Online, do our case, it's all over. We expect to get an answer back from the court like that. And then the police have to act on our orders to uplift the property in Cook Street and other property. The motel in Rotten Point will be seized off those owners there. They were warned, the real estate company, you're going to lose your property, you're going to lose everything in your business, Bailey's and Barford and Thompson. You're going to lose all your business and Ray White's for tampering with our contracts while they were private contracts and defaulted contracts with Cook Street and other properties you have seized, and even the one down in Tongarunui that I've got my name on that was taken, stolen by the Crown. That'll be returned. And the properties in Awaro are in Ruatore, Awanui, Hau 7B block, and the block in down on the beach towards what's the name of that place? Anyway, Heringa, A12, Heringa A12 block. The Heringa 11, the Heringa 12, all those blocks I was going after, we're going to seize them off here. Those owners there are arrogant, ignorant of what I'm saying as the original commercial landowners. You're not the landowners. None of anybody in the world that have been seized on their lands owns the land, really. It belongs to the Crown. And we are the Crown. The Moai Crown. Memorial. Standing in London. Okay, because that's all come from this flag. So that's what I wanted to really say, is that I'm alerting our Paramount Chiefs that I've just got an email from Te Unga Waka Marae, Paula Hakaraya, that we can have the marae, but I'll confirm it with her tomorrow and pay whatever it is for the marae. We all have full capacity, 30, sleeps 30, and those will be put aside for the old people, kaumātuism, queers, who come there. It's a business meeting. It's a court hearing meeting. It's not there just to learn. This is a straight out British court case. This is for people who know what I'm doing online, and it's not worth your while coming if you are not up to this level of authority. So please, if you're coming, it's okay to come to the meeting in the daytime at 3 o'clock to witness the event. It's public. We're there for the public, for the 70% of the population of New Zealand. We're there for. This has nothing to do with the Queen or this government or anybody on the Queen's side. This is strictly to do with Westminster Magistrate Court, the High Court of Admiralty Court in London, the Prime Minister of Britain, UK, Theresa May, the First Lord of the Sea, Sir Philip Jones, and the Foreign Minister, and also Philip Hammond, Secretary of State, Treasury. So they're our partners, they're our legal partners in this grand jury magistrate court hearing. They're party to it. They are the recipient of this flag and what we recover from debtors all over the world, including the EU Parliament, is a debtor of the Queen and the Jesuits. I must put those ones in. The Jesuits are running the racket with the Queen. She's the head Jesuit or Jesuit. And Pope Francis is a Jesuit. He's the one that's organising the business. He's got that bill, 970 million trillion pound note on his head. And we're drawing straight off that to pay the British military 10 billion to recover all the debt. The first 10 billion out of this pound note we have to go and recover all the stolen wealth from HM Treasury. All the land stolen in the world by the Queen and her royal family. And we're using the acts of King William III, King William IV, and King George IV to hang them, anyone we want, if the 70% say so, of the population of the world from Britain, and 70% of each country in 250 countries. If 70% of those people in those countries make a claim to the Maui Crown King William IV Trust, then it's open for business. It's already open for business from a 21-gun salute on the 6th of February 2017 up in Te Tiki Marae. It's on YouTube. You can see it there. And on the 15th of April 2016 in the Waitangi Marae Native Grand Jury Trial Magistrate Court hearing. And that's on video, YouTube, cited fact. Evidence, the event did happen. It's on the record. The team arrives on the record to the Magistrate Court in Britain and the Magistrate Court in Edinburgh, where all the titles are under the then retired Prince Philip, Commander-in-Chief Mischief, ran away because we know that he's pulled out, and the Queen abandoned ship as well. This is Admiralty I'm talking about, in the Magistrate Court in Edinburgh, where Prince Philip has been sitting there on this fortune for themselves and running amok in the Navy, the Royal British Navy, from there, from Edinburgh, and the Freemasons in Edinburgh, their main office there. They get a bill too. They get a bill too for putting their symbols all over this country and claiming it as if they own it. No. The crown, this crown, owns it. And this king, Ernest Augustus V, is our legal partner because we say so. This flag says so. It's the contract that says so. It's a receipt of our business, commercial banking, trading business. That's still live. Continuity of sovereignty since 1830 and 1820. From 1820 to 1830, Te Rawaikato Wharehere Manukau, the Moriori, who sold this land in New Zealand and Pacific Islands, Chatham Islands being part of the Pacific Islands, and Cook Islands being Cook Islands here, and Cook Islands there. That's, so we encompass the whole of Pacific Islands as claimants in this court hearing. So I'm leaving that wide open for non-ignorant people to make your claim. Once we open the office up in Auckland, we're going straight onto Cook Street and seize the whole place. For those tenants there, there are 43 people who got in my road and tampered with my contract, the private contract I had with those two owners. You're in the gun. Your names go on to the court hearing on the 29th, and it goes, after that court hearing, it's only a 2-hour case, it goes straight into London High Court, and they make a ruling, because you never turn up, or you better turn up, because if you don't, it's going ahead. And there's no way you're going to get out of this one, because there's too much online. That's what the judge said in the court, in Auckland District Court. Shannon Withers was my barrister. He's in the gun. Shannon Withers, you're watching this video, you're liable. You've got £1 trillion on your head. Your queen can pay the rest of it, and all the other thugs in the corporations, 30%. They get the bill, all of you. Okay, so you did not do my citations or did not make my own court hearing that I wanted. Now I'm making my court hearing, the one that you didn't finish off for me in that courthouse. I'm going in to make this court, and your name is on it as a criminal, fraudster. You all covered up the conspiracy to defraud the public of New Zealand and the Paramount Chiefs, commercial landowners. You defrauded them and think you're going to get away with it, because there's no one that is checking you of all your illegal activity except us. So, your name, John Key, James Pierce Brown, the landowner on Cook Street, and Simon Brent Roundtree, CIB, Natalie Flower Dew Brown, Aaron Pascoe, and Tim Duffy, they're going in there too. Also, Sean Elias, Chief Justice of the Supreme Court of New Zealand, crook. I can hook the whole lot of you into the fraud at the same time as Judith Collins, Minister of Police. All the police ministers are fraud. They cover up the fraud in Auckland Central Police Station and cover up the fraud of the land agents, Westpac, and any other. We're going to do a thorough investigation, contracted to Britain, to open you all up to that fraud land transaction that I registered an interest in that land with Mohi Manukau, and you failed in the Lins to put the Manukau's name on the titles. So for that, you're liable. The whole country, because we're saying it's a Manukau title. Nobody else, because they can't prove anything. I not see Tainui with a whole country title. I can't see Arawa with a whole country title. There was none, because I've got all the titles original from Mohi Manukau passed over to me. He didn't trust his own family. He left it to me. The Rogans married his family and my family, the judges. And that's why no one can't get nothing. The birth certificate says it all. And St. Mary's Church in Tiki Tiki says it all. That's the birth, death and marriages certificates on this 8-point star St. Patrick's Church. Those two churches go together on our titles. And those are in the magistrate court hearing as well. So unless anyone can prove and defend themselves, or anybody in this country or the world for that matter, has got any information better than that. That's why I won my case, or the police had insufficient evidence against what I have online. 106 Facebook sites, 1170 YouTube videos, over 3,000 business followers on Twitter, and our website, and a good measure of exposure with all this information sitting in front of you online is admissible in any court of law, and that's what's going to get you. So a warning to all those people I name, and your names on Facebook in a box or named, you're liable £1 trillion each. You won't have £1 trillion, but the balance goes to the whole 30% of all the people who don't join in this side. So out of 70%, I'm expecting at least some to make claims when it starts moving. Okay, I'm making this announcement wide awake, fit as hell, in my right mind, on this video, to show you who I am and what authority I have, given by my paramount chiefs, and I've given them authority all the same to do what they have to do to take back to the old Komatuas, who give it back to them to give it to me. And that's how it works. That's how it works. There is no need to go any further with any law here, because it cannot have jurisdiction higher than a king. And I'm acting for the kings, because nobody in this world is. Because they can't. They haven't got a flag to claim that right. Or jurisdiction, or authority, or constitution. 1852 constitution is what we're using in this flag. And our own Maui Crown constitution. You'll see it on my Facebook site and on my website, moaipowerhouse.com. Enough information's there, but it'll start rattling along soon with the shares. It's £25 a share, one off, that's it. You would never have to buy any more shares, because there's no need to. The £25 is to make a contribution to register your name to claim all these trillions that's sitting in this authority flag. Okay, the paramount chiefs have given me the authority to use this flag's authority, because it's still live. It's legal. Not the 1835 Declaration of Independence, because the government here legislated out. They cannot legislate the British title out. It's a real flag, and we have made it legal on the 6th of February 2017 with a 21-gun salute banging off in the background on the video, and also in Waitangi Marae, King's Bench, Native Grand Jury Trial Magistrate Court, on 15th of April 2016. That's also cited fact evidence on YouTube. We had a police, Paul Tiepen, there to witness that lot, and Morris, the Marae keeper was there as well, Maori Rapala. He let us in to have that historic court hearing. That was a court hearing. that's how we do our court hearings. It's not for anybody to say how we write, how we say things, how we explain ourselves in writing. That's our law. When I write, it's our law. You can't say anything. Better not comment too much, because it can go against you if you abuse us or accuse us while we're in this authority now. Okay, so that's all I want to really say for now. And I'll make another video of more detail of what's going to happen with those people I'm naming. I'll have them listed out. There'll be a manual for the Paramount Chiefs to take into the court. Any Marae, they can go into any court, they can go into any council with this 8-point star authority, not John Key wearing that 8-point star. He's got to prove where he got it from and who gave it to him, what for, and who gave him the authority to wear it. Because while we're in a contract, two-party contract, he can't mess around with our symbols and our authority. That's our authority. That's our sheriff's authority on our flag and our brand name title. It is our patent brand name land title. And court to pick up the money, pick up the fines, pick up the debts, pick up the rates, the rent, pick up the fines and stolen property and everything, tax and debts from overseas and overseas businesses that have got investments out of here. We're going after anybody in the world with this flag. It's a world flag in 250 countries that will capture anybody, anywhere, anytime, anyhow. Okay, that's all. Today is Saturday, the 19th of August 2017. We'll bid you good evening, and we'll see you later. Bye for now.